Foxy, if we can cut it down to Houston hotel room with Pat and I believe Connor is with him, correct? Oh, hey, boys.
Hey. Show's going great. You know, open about, what, 5 to 10 seconds late there, Fox? AJ, right through the beat drop, you're wearing a suit? Okay, you look good. And Jason McIntyre is a human in the sports media world already. Okay, don't need to do that to my brother.
Come on,
Connor, you look fantastic.
Thanks, Pat. You know what? You look great, too.
No, you look good.
No, you look good.
Not as good as AJ Hawk wearing a full suit.
Come on, that guy today. Are you kidding me?
Is that every day? Now?
It has to be.
Oh, are you wearing suits every day now, AJ? You look amazing. Thank you for doing what you're doing. Houston's hot. We're having a great time, and we are going to get kicked out of our hotel, so we can't wait to watch and listen as we can here, bub.
Well, I tell you what is hot is this studio. I don't know if you can see me profusely sweating. It is blazing down here. It's usually like 48 degrees. Pat keeps these like Letterman's got to keep the studio nice and cool so he can really, his brain works the best, but I'll tell you what, it's about 95 in here when it comes to me. I don't know how you guys feel.
I mean, I feel okay. AJ was pitting out early before he even walked into the studio. Yeah. So, I mean, yeah.
It's hot in the kitchen, AJ. Yeah.
Well, no, it's something about...
It's hot in the kitchen.
It's something about when you wear... when I wear dress clothes, I wear something nice, I instantly just start sweating. There's something like mentally that I got to find a way to get over, right?
Well, normally when you dress up, you have to go to an event that is going to be absolutely fucking terrible. Yeah. So I think that is kind of the mental part of it all. You know, like, okay, not only do I have to wear this clown suit that is too hot, all right? Not only do I have to wear this Amish thing around my neck to make people think that I am more professional than they are, looking like a
stooge in a clown.
Okay, but the what I'm saying is, I think it's not just the physical thing you're wearing. I think it's also the mental thought. Why are you dressed like that? I think you are doing an incredible service to that desk. You're making it look professional, everything like that.
This desk is awful. This is getting, it's getting tighter and tighter. Like, I was here how many months ago?
Four, maybe.
I walked in, and the first thing I said to everybody, are you serious? This desk? Like, it's getting worse. There's less and less room to even move. Like, if I end up knocking all these sheets down, please don't be upset, Pat, because it may happen. It's already about to topple because you have 7,000 sheets right here along with everything else in the world.
Hey, that's your guess? Is that your guess? Because we do have a giveaway going on with those sheets. It's 7,000. You're the one who has an eye on it. You know, everybody on the internet is wondering how many sheets are in there. I will say that desk, and the boys will attest to this back there, and since Connor's here with me, I guess he could do it. Connor can pop in.
Of course.
I've even said that that desk has become, are you okay?
I need a towel. I need a towel.
Rolling rolling at the mouth.
Take the suit off, dude.
No way, man. I'm professional.
Huh?
I'm professional. I'm trying to bring some class to this studio, to this seat. You know, you got to figure it out.
This guy. Out of here.
This guy.
Come
on. Ty.
We'll this guy.
What is going on? Connor's, you know, you've got a chance to meet Green Bay Packer folklore, you know, all-time leading tackler, all-time leading passer. I think, Ty, you've been a great owner of the Packers.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
I'm sitting here, by the way, because the camera, whenever it splits, I got, you know, we got full couch, but I can't. And it's also nice to be next to this guy. But, Ty, when AJ walks in and says, this studio, this office is normally despicable, I need to clean it up a little bit, and puts that full clown suit on and walks in there, what are your immediate thoughts about a hero, a guy that you probably had a poster of up in the bedroom whenever you were growing up?
Yeah, I had the fat head. I mean, it hurts, obviously. I mean, you know, I've come to know AJ, you know, pretty decently over the last, what, 2 years, 3 years or whatever, but I mean, it was a cheap shot. There's no question about it. Luckily, he has not pissed on the floor yet,
which we know
he loves doing that every time he comes here. So I think that'll kind of be like the final, you know, knife in the back if that is to happen today.
I mean, absolute blasphemy, Pat. You know that. Whoever did piss all over
Watch
your floor,
that.
It was not
hey.
Me. What?
Watch that saber sword.
Careful.
Dude.
Why do you have this? For the serious listeners, I know Pat doesn't refer to you very often. I'm holding a big old scepter, I believe they call it, that he had tucked away in the corner of his office.
I will say, serious listeners, I appreciate you every day, even more so today. But to be completely candid, we make all of our money and all of our reference points are often numbers that do not involve you, because Sirius gives us no numbers at all. So I'm not saying personally it is a zero, but every business move that is made, the Sirius number is at zero. So we have no idea if people actually listen. But what AJ is holding is a sword straight out of Game of Thrones, I think. Zito bought that at an auction straight out of Game of Thrones. It was a gift to me, and now you're mocking it, obviously.
It was real? Whatever. Wait, this is real? Like, this was used in the show?
On set, yeah.
Yeah, by the Dothraki.
They actually severed a head with that.
About as realistic as the guy that they said was Aaron Rodgers on that episode, where he was running all duck-footed.
Hey, he was running. That was the best part of that whole thing. Do we know where he was? Has he ever said it? I know we asked him, and he got mad at a lot of people that thought that that unathletic-looking some bitch that went into the alley and then died was him. But did we ever find out where he was?
We never did. I mean, he tried to tell us where he was, I guess, but I don't know. Like, I have no clue where he was. Like, what did
what
he do?
What else does he tell?
Is there any
Connor,
behind the
scenes? Aaron told you. Has Aaron told you anything?
Aaron hasn't really talked to me lately. I did call him last night just to kind of check in. Hey, Aaron, we're in Houston. It's great down here. I don't know what you're thinking about Texas, but it's great. You know, I was just hoping he was doing well, really.
Yeah, so he doesn't really talk to you much. How about you, guy wearing a suit, hosting a sports show? Have you heard anything from this guy? You're breaking news. You're on Get Up. Okay. Oh. AJ Hawk says da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. You're on Colin Cowherd's show yesterday. He didn't give us credit, but he did give you credit. You might have said it on his show, to be honest, because you have been saying the same thing this entire time, and it's just getting recycled as breaking news.